Hello, hello everyone, and welcome on back to the channel. Today, we are doing a tutorial on this super cute little greenhouse build. It's really spruce heavy with a bunch of dark oak accents weaving our way through the trees here. The back is very, very similar to the front, and it's just a really, really nice little build. You can keep some bees in here or even add in your own automatic flower farm. Just on the inside, I've hung a bunch of bee nests up. We've got leaves and greenery everywhere, which I think is so, so fun, and a tiny little bee farm here in the middle. So that is basically the build in a quick wrap-up summary. So let's head straight into the block palette. So what we've got here is the block palette for the exterior of the build. Everything you're gonna need for the interior, it's just a bunch of lush little bits and pieces, just greenery, bees nests, maybe some spruce and oak trapdoor accents, all of that. And of course for the exterior, what you're gonna need is all right here. You're gonna wanna have some dark oak fence, chains, lanterns, spruce logs, dark oak buttons, spruce wood, spruce door, dark oak trapdoor, dark oak stair, dark oak slab, dark oak gate, glass pane, mossy cobble stair, stone brick stair, cobble stair, and some grass or dirt. If you're ready to get all of that together, let's head straight into the dimensions for this one. This greenhouse really isn't a very big build. You're just gonna need a little 12x7 rectangle of space set out somewhere wherever you would like it to be. And once you have that all sorted, let's head straight into the tutorial. So we're gonna start off with the support and the frame of our little greenhouse. So grab your spruce logs and come in first here on the corner. Then a gap of 3, next one, gap of 2, gap of 3. Turn the corner, leave the whole gap of 5, that one there, turn the corner again, gap of 3, gap of 2, gap of 3. And these are the spots for our little support beams for the build. Next, keeping with the spruce logs, we're bringing all of these up by 7 for a total of 8. So we've got one here on the bottom, then we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then again, we're repeating that all the way around and bringing them all up to 8 high. Then after bringing all of your pillars up, keeping with the spruce logs, we're going to bring 2 spruce logs up on every outside facing piece of all of our support beams. So going all the way around and just on the outside here, we are bringing up all of these little bits of log. And then from that point, grab your dark oak stairs and we're just capping off all of those logs. Then grabbing your spruce logs again, we are connecting up all of our support beams, one down from the top, just like this, all the way around. And then as well, we are poking our logs out just on that same level as those support beams, all the way around once more. Now, grabbing our dark oak stairs, we're also placing those underneath all of those beams we just poked out. And grabbing our dark oak buttons, we're popping those onto the ends of all of these little beams. Now we're going to create the frame of our little arches up here at the top. So first grab your dark oak stairs and place them all facing inwards just like this on top of each of these logs. Then grabbing your spruce wood just for this little bit here, you're going to be placing one piece of spruce wood on the inside of each of those stair pieces, then stairs once more on top of that. Then again with your spruce logs, just connect up those top bits of the stairs. Now to add some more detail to these little arches, pop one spruce slab in the very center of those all the way along, and then dark oak trapdoors to either side of that slab on top. And you can add these trapdoors in as well, just on the outside facing arches where the trapdoors are, just like this. Then as well, you can wrap this lower log's outside facing parts with the dark oak trapdoors as well, just going all the way around. Now with our frame looking super cute like this already, you're going to want to grab your mixture of our stone stairs. So cobble stairs, stone brick stairs, and mossy cobble stairs, and we're coming down to the bottom here and starting to build in our walls. So starting with our little doorway, it doesn't really matter which you use for what, but we're just popping stairs like this here in the middle. Really, you could use blocks or slabs for these ones because it is just a floor, but may as well use the stairs because we've got them already. And then with that first little bit of our stair action here, ready for a door to be added in. We're moving to the sides for our wall and modeling through our little texture selection, something just like that, with the first and lower row there at the standard orientation and the one above turned upside down, so it creates this little dip in the middle. And we're just repeating that all the way around, running through our mixture of our stairs and facing them in towards each other and making some just really fun random patterns, repeating something just like this all the way around through all of these other segments. All right, I'll quickly fly you around. This is what the finished little stone segment should look like. It really doesn't matter what piece of the texture goes where, as long as you kind of get this messy impression of a bit of broken up stone there at the base. Now grab your spruce wood again and some dark oak stairs, and we're gonna start adding in our places for our glass windows. So in all of these three wide sections, it's a stair either side like this and a piece of the wood in the middle. So stair, stair, piece of wood. Over here, stair, stair, piece of wood, and over here, stair, stair, piece of wood. Then, right here, two bits of wood there in the middle. Round on these sides, it's wood in these places and three stairs, just like that, repeating it over here. And then, round the front here, count up two and put some upside down dark oak stairs right there. As well, adding those dark oak stairs around on the other side, just like this. Next, grab your glass and glass panes, and we're gonna start adding in the glass, which is really gonna pull this build together. So for all the outside walls, every spot where you've got the piece of spruce wood is where your glass blocks are gonna go. So just like this, all the way around on top of our spruce wood, except for these little two wide sections. We'll come back to those ones in a second. And then of course, filling in all the gaps with our glass panes. And now that our main windows are in, grab your glass blocks again and pop those up at the top and then the panes underneath them in these two wide sections. So same again around the back, glass blocks and then the panes underneath. Now moving up to the top with our glass, we're just repeating the same pattern from underneath with our blocks and panes up in these segments. And once that is done on the other side as well, we just need our blocks to fill in the roof, and we're matching it up with where all of our log or spruce wood bits are. So you'll get this nice little curved shape that lines right up with our log frame, and we're repeating that in every single segment up here. Now with all of our wall sections filled in with glass just like this, all the way around, you're gonna wanna grab your spruce doors, and we're coming in through the front here and placing them just like this. And now adding a few final touches here to the outside, grab your dark oak fence gates and we're running those along, connecting up all of these logs that stick out, leaving the corners which we are filling with our fence pieces instead. Then with that connected up all the way around the gates and fence pieces just like this, we're grabbing some chains and lanterns. So I do of course like to alternate my chains and lanterns if you've watched any of my other tutorials, so I'm popping a chain and a lantern here on the left and just a lantern here on the right. Then again a chain and a lantern and just a lantern again for a little bit of that variation that I really love. Now you can grab a fence piece as well and pop that there with a lantern on top for that bit of extra attention drawn to your entranceway. And then popping into the inside, grabbing your dirt or your grass, we are just raising up this floor by one. And there we go, the floor is all raised up and ready for us to get straight into adding a little bit of interior. Now I'm not gonna run you guys through every single detail of the interior for this one, but I am gonna give you some basic pointers and show you a few things that I think really help this build come to life. So first off here on the inside, we're gonna be connecting up some more support beams just in these two places right there, then with some barrels popping out what is in the middle and adding barrels there instead. Then some dark oak stairs underneath just for that extra bit of support, and it is already looking a lot nicer in here. Then another thing that I think makes a big difference in how lush and vibrant this build looks are just the leaf details that we can add and run around all up the top. So I really like using a mixture of oak, spruce, and flowering azalea, and we can just kind of start draping these all the way around, adding them in as we would like here. Maybe swap this out. And it really doesn't matter too much. What this is about is just filling in the space, because it does look pretty empty and bland in here when it's all just the glass, but as soon as you start bringing in the life, it really starts to come together. So just continuing to go around with our leaves and kind of just snaking them just like this and mottling through them all over the inside here, creating this much, much nicer lush look. Really, it doesn't matter if they're attached to anything, feel free to just paste them against the glass just as I have, and it's gonna make a pretty big difference in how lush and vibrant this build feels. And just my big tip for this is if you're looking around and seeing anywhere that looks a bit empty, just add some leaves in. It makes such a difference. So what I'm seeing is this spot up here is still looking a little bare, so I'm just gonna chuck a few more leaves in. And here we are. I'm giving you a quick peek without the fluffy leaves on, which the fluffy leaves are thanks to Jermzy Boy's Better Leaf Texture Pack if you're interested. I do think they look a lot better than the square leaves, but just to give you a better view of the kind of leaf placement I've gone for here. And that is kind of all I'm gonna really run you through for the interior of this one. The rest really depends how much function you want this build to have. So as you saw in the model one, I do just have two bee houses right like this. If you wanted to extend that, you could perhaps have four there in the middle, or you can even run them along either side just like this to really maximize, as well as adding some here if you liked. That would probably be the best amount of bees you could get out of this one without going absolutely crazy. But let's quickly pop back into the model build and I can just talk you through a little more of what I've done in here. So the first thing you're gonna notice is just this super cute little path I've got leading up to the main event, which is of course my tiny bee nest. I've wrapped these ones in our mottle of oak and spruce trapdoors with the campfires just underneath for safety, of course. I've got a little bit of moss and mossy carpet in the floors and just a bunch of flowers and ferns, as well as glowberries and bee nests hanging from the roof. Fun trick with the glowberries, just use a little bit of string to stop them from hanging too far down so they don't go absolutely crazy. And I've also added some spore blossoms up here in the top center of each of these side segments, just because I think the particle effect is really, really nice and adds a lot to the atmosphere in here. Of course, again, just a little bit of chest, barrel, and ender chest action tucked into these corners, and that is about it here for this greenhouse. And just here on the outside, I've got the usual path scheme and just a bunch of lush greenery all the way around, a tiny bit of custom tree action, as well as some modified standard big trees. That splash of the azalea leaf really looks so nice there. And you are all done with your wonderful, super cute little greenhouse build. I hope you've loved seeing this build come together just as much as I have loved creating it. I hope you really enjoy having it in your worlds, whether they are creative or survival. And of course, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, let me know what your favorite thing is about today's little greenhouse build. And again, thank you so, so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye!